Hello, my name is Jeffrey Butensky, and I am an American whose roots can be traced back to Eastern Europe through Argentina. Although my great-great-grandparents were born in Bessarabia, in Eastern Europe, three generations of my family before me have been born and raised in Argentina. Thanks to the philanthropic efforts of Baron Mauricio de Hirsch at the turn of the 20th century. In order to escape persecution and attacks in Eastern Europe, Baron Hirsch established three colonies in the Americas as religious havens. One of the colonies was established in New Jersey, the second in Saskatchewan, Canada, and the third in Argentina. This following video concerns the colony in Argentina, how it thrived, how it faded, and how it forever remains in many people's hearts. Although the history of this colony was almost lost, during the last 25 years, there has been a renewed interest in this valuable cultural legacy. A special museum sprung up in order to help maintain this history. This museum in Dominguez, the geographic center of one of the colonies in Argentina, has been able, since 1985, to amass much unique and important documentation about life in these colonies. However, due to lack of funds, this museum has been facing the constant threat of extinction ever since the inauguration. My quest is to create awareness with younger generations and to help raise funds for the museum, because if it does not get the money needed, it could fade away, and the history of an entire Jewish colony could be lost forever in time. Please enjoy the following presentation of this small museum that I hold so closely to my heart. Through its museum, Villa Dominguez keeps alive the memory of a key part of Jewish life and history in Argentina. Its agricultural colonies were established by Baron Mauricio de Hirsch. This extraordinary movement to Argentina, which took place at the end of the 19th century and during the beginning of the 20th, had as an objective to give numerous opportunities to the Jews immigrating to Argentina to work the agricultural colonies. These Jews had previously been suffering in attacks and persecutions in Tsarist Russia. Entre Rios was already considered the land of immigrants thanks to the missionary action of General Urquiza, who in the mid-1800s proposed the establishment of the first agricultural colonies in Argentina to prominent Jewish families from different European backgrounds. On December of 1891, the first group of families, recruited by the Jewish Colonization Association and funded by the Baron Mauricio de Hirsch, arrived at Buenos Aires port. After suffering various inconveniences and after a long trip that took them to the port of Concepcion de Uruguay, the first families finally arrived by train on March of 1892 to the Dominguez train station in what is the geographic center of the Entre Rios province. What is today the town of Dominguez was a first-hand witness to the Jewish colonization in this province. Those first immigrants, many of whom in Europe were artisans or small-time merchants, were forced to learn to labor in an inhospitable and unknown region. However, at the same time, they managed to maintain their beliefs and customs. The new immigrants were finally able to plant their seeds into the fertile landscape. Not only did they begin planting the wheat seeds, but also the seeds of liberty, since their children were able to grow up without persecution. The new arrival of Jewish colonists gave way to the foundation of dozens of towns, like Villa Dominguez in Argentina, and the establishment of numerous schools, hospitals, synagogues, libraries, theaters, and aid associations, many of which are still functioning today.
My father would tell me that the first years in the colony were very tough. He would learn from the natives to tame oxen and to maneuver himself on the natural terrain of San Gregorio to find the oxen that would run away from the colonists. Afterwards, when he was a little bit older, he also learned from the natives to ride horses. He truly was a Jewish gaucho.
The positive interaction between the locals and the Jewish colonists gave way to a new image. This image was one of Jews on horseback that Alberto Herchunov immortalized with the name Jewish Gauchos, which in English means Jewish cowboy.
My grandparents came from Russia on the ship Pampa, one of the first boats utilized by Baron Hirsch. I went with my uncle to work in the 11th colony, in which I would study with my boss's children and along with many people that lived in that colony. When I was 15 or 16 years old, I would go to Sakharov, to the ballroom, for the dance and the parties. I would go on horseback, wearing a suit.
Villa Dominguez still conserves the original urban design from 1897 by the French surveyor Aristide Sol, who was employed by the Jewish Colonization Association to design a town of European likeness. From a circular central plaza sprout many diagonal streets that gave the town a completely distinct look compared to the usual Argentinian town designs. For this reason, many people call Villa Dominguez the Paris in Entre Rios, even though its dirt roads are often traveled by tractors and horse-drawn carriages. In front of the central plaza is the original town synagogue, constructed in 1923, which one can reach by walking along a small path bordered by poplars. Also in front of the central plaza is the first Jewish hospital of South America. Today it is called Dr. Noah Yarcho in honor of the doctor who founded it in 1893. On one of the main diagonal avenues, San Martin Avenue, one can find a building that will spark a lot of interest in visitants to Villa Dominguez. This building is called the Hotel for Immigrants. It is a sturdy warehouse made of wood that was once used by the Jewish Colonization Association to house colonists until the time came to assign them their own areas of land, areas in which they would work agriculturally. 100 meters from the warehouse is the old Dr. Yarcho Pharmacy, home today to the museum. This building, which was constructed more than 70 years ago, to this day holds the antiquated cash register and the original carved oak furniture, furniture carved by immigrants from Russia and Poland.
I became the mayor of Dominguez. In the beginning of my administration, a history professor from the city of Concepcion de Uruguay visited me. On October 19th, 1985, led by Professor Celia Lopez and with a group of local neighbors, we inaugurated the museum and the regional historical archives of the Jewish colonies. We began to relive our history, the history of a town that was the cradle of the Jewish Gauchos.